Home dealer for yellow wood treated lumber. Harris Ace will not be undersold on price, so you know you're getting the best price at Harris Ace. Your favorite place for hardware and lumber supplies is Harris Ace Hardware, West Cherry Street in Jessup.
It's time to slap on those aprons and put on your dancing shoes. Join us on June 15th as Live Oak Ranch hosts their very first backyard barbecue cook-off and June Jam. We're kicking off the summer nice and hot with a barbecue cook-off and all-day music featuring a concert with Stephen Harrell and the Dusty Boots Band. Food and refreshments will be provided, as well as a foam pit and double racer water slide for the kids. Admission price $15 for adults, $5 for kids. Children 3 and under get in free. So mark your calendars for Saturday, June 15th from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. at the Barn at Live Oak Ranch. If you think your barbecue has what it takes to compete, entry forms are online at www.thebarnatliveoakranch.com. This event will take place on the lawn, so don't forget your blankets and chairs. Again, that's Saturday, June 15th from 10 a.m. until 10 p.m. at the Barn at Live Oak Ranch, located on Highway 169. We hope to see you there.
Our customers comes first at First Franklin Financial. It's not just a slogan, it's the way we do business. Since 1941, we've been helping our friends and neighbors in the Southeast with their financial needs. We offer personal loans, bill consolidation loans, and more. So stop by our office today. We're conveniently located at 1074 North Macon Street, or give us a call at 912-427-4237. You can also start your application online at www.1ffc.com. All loan terms and applicable APR depends on meeting our underwriting and income criteria for the loan size requested and may require collateral. Georgia Residential Mortgage Licensee, number 5656.
And then a Walker Jones.
June is all about Silverado and Walker Jones Chevrolet. With all new 2018 Chevy Silverados sold at GM employee prices. And you keep all the rebates. Total discounts up to $14,000. Or choose 0% for 72 months. And up to $2,250 in down payment assistance from GM Financial. Or get a new 2019 Silverado Crew Cab 1LT or RST. And take $9,000 off. Or 0% for 72 months. Find new roads at Walker Jones Chevy.
Restrictions apply. See dealer for details and 639.
Saturday, June 22nd, Wild Adventures Theme Park in Valdosta, Georgia presents 2019 Grammy Award winners Dan and Shay.
Nothing like you.
It's the Wild Adventures All-Star Concert Series featuring Dan and Shay live in concert Saturday, June 22nd.
I'm speechless.
Concert admission is included with your park admission or season pass. Get your tickets for Dan and Shay live in concert Saturday, June 22nd at wildadventures.com.
Local news on WIFO.
It's time now for a look at least in local news and advisement for City of Jessup residents. There's a broken water line on Oakfield Drive. If you live in the area of Oakfield Drive, Adair Street, or Ivy Street, the city's asking that you continue to boil your water before drinking it until this Wednesday, June 12th at 12 noon. In the city working on repairing the line, but again, boil your water before drinking it at this time. And the broken water line on Oakville Drive, again, they state the areas affected are Oakville Drive, Adair Street, and Ivy Street. County Commissioners met for the second time in executive session on Monday, last Monday for close to 90 minutes behind closed doors, Monday for just about 10 minutes. When they came back to open session, it became apparent that the personnel discussed in the closed sessions was County Administrator Ed Jeffords, who in the minds of Commissioners Kevin McCreary and Ralph Hickox was not transparent with budget items. In a statement made in open session, Commissioner McCreary states that approximately $1.2 million was spent by unauthorized approval to shift money from one department to another to cover over budget spending, which is not compliant with Georgia state law. Commissioner Ralph Hickox wanted some form of disciplinary action. Kevin McCreary on board with that, but it's also apparent that the other three commissioners not on board and not in agreement with Commissioners Hickox and McCreary. No action taken in the executive session, but that forced McCreary and Hickox to make statements and those statements to the media at the meeting. Here's Kevin McCreary's statement that he made in open session Monday after the executive session.
Please keep in mind I'm not here to crucify anyone. I believe as an elected commissioner, all of us, that it is our duty to enforce all rules and regulations, to hold each person accountable to their job duties, and report to the elected body. I ran for office saying I would go through the budget line by line, which I did for about 2.5 weeks. I also said I would be transparent with the information I find, whether it's reported the good or the bad. Based on the information given to the board on the 2018 budget March of this year, After further investigation and talking to the ACCG, county managers in other counties and administrators, the actions found were not in compliance with the Georgia law or our county ordinance. When I first looked over the amended budget, which is called the cheat sheet given to the commissioners, I noticed the numbers did not match up with the original budget sheet for December 31st, 2018, provided to the board earlier in January and March of 2019. When I brought this to the board's attention, not one commissioner would make a motion to approve the amended budget given by Mr. Jeffords. Commissioner Hickox and I were nominated to speak with Mr. Jeffords in private to see if there were any misconceptions on my part, because I had only been a commissioner for 3 months, which is understandable, and all of our questions concluded that my assumptions were correct. There was money that was not spent in some departments, but was shown on the amended budget sheet as spent. This was misleading information presented to the Board of Commissioners by saying we only came $1,000 under our original 2018 approved budget, stated clearly on the cheat sheet, when in fact it was almost $2 million under 2018 budget originally approved, which is great for the county. However, keep in mind the 2019 budget was approved for $23.4 million prior to me taking office, when we only spent around $21 million in 2018. Approximately $1.2 million was spent by unauthorized approval to shift the money from one department to another to cover for over budget spending, which is not compliant with Georgia state law. I also noticed that there was money spent on several non-specific line items that were never approved in the original 2018 budget, which I still haven't been given an answer as to what the money was spent on. Adding line items are an improper procedure according to the Wayne County Ordinance. This is an ordinance Mr. Jeffords helped write and sign when he was a county commissioner to prevent this very thing from happening. Budget items that are going to go over the original yearly department budget should be brought before the Board of Commissioners before they are spent and cannot be approved by the administrator or anyone else like it has been being done in the past. Those amendments must also be approved by the Board of Commissioners and no other entity before the fiscal year ends, according to the Georgia governing law. I am told that this is a culture that has been going on for years by Ed and the other commissioners. With our county and financial state that it is in now, I think I can safely say that this is a culture not working anymore, and it is not in the guidelines set in the Georgia law and Wayne County ordinance. In saying all of this, I realize it is my duty as one of your county commissioners, given authority by the governor of Georgia, to correct or bring to the Board of Commissioners to correct anything that is not compliant or against our oath of office. Since April, I have brought the evidence of wrongful doing clearly to the board to handle this situation in a manner that would be appeasing to rectify the problem. A slap on the hand apparently does not work anymore. I asked for concrete resolution to the problem and I didn't feel this has been justified to prevent this from ever happening again. It is unacceptable for insubordinate acts like these to be allowed. I acknowledge that I will not take any part of budgeting process that does not comply with Georgia law or Wayne County ordinances, and I will try my best to protect the taxpayers' money and the county to the best of my ability. Do I believe that we can get this county under control with spending? Sure I do, as long as the commission works together and hold each department accountable for their budget. The commissioner should be held accountable for the spending of taxpayers' money, not just the administrator. However, the administrator should also be held accountable to follow proper procedures of the Georgia law and the county ordinances, which is not happening now. I am committing myself to give the administrator and take... I am committing myself to give the administrator the support that he needs and take the pressure off of him. It is the commissioner's duty to approve or not approve budget changes before they happen. I realize change is never easy. If we don't make these changes now and hold people accountable for their actions, the problem will not ever get any or not ever be rectified. This is one of the many steps we need to take to get back on track. My integrity, transparency, and commitment to myself and this county is not up for negotiation.
And again, those comments of Kevin McCreary at the meeting Monday after the executive session. We'll be back with more from the meeting. Administrator Ed Jeffers not in agreement with McCreary's statement. We'll hear the administrator's response after these commercial messages.
The Trademart at 3689 Savannah Highway has been serving Wayne County and surrounding counties for over 30 years. If it's a small hand tool you're looking for or a 30-ton bearing press, we've got it. You need a tarp? We've got you covered. We have any size you need, from a 5x7 to a 30x60. So if you need a quality tool at an affordable price, come see us at The Trademart, 3689 Savannah Highway, or call us at 427-6966. That's 427-6966. The Trademart, the tool supply place.
Do you need a new lawnmower? If so, head to Knight Saw Company in Baxley. Choose from a large selection of name brand mowers. Knight Saw Company offers the best lawnmowers at the best prices anywhere. They also have in stock belts, batteries, and parts for all mowers, along with name brand trimmers, blowers, and hedge trimmers. For over 50 years, Wayne Countyans have been getting their power lawn equipment and parts from Knight's. Knight Saw Company on the Jessup side of Baxley on Highway 341. For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
The Strand Bistro, an Italian and American eatery, gives you the wow factor in your dining experience. Right now at the Strand Bistro, you can enjoy a 5-course meal prepared by Chef John Paula for only $21. This meal includes bread, choice of side salad, choice of appetizer, choice of entree, choice of dessert, and an after-meal specialty coffee. This dinner special is from 5 to 9 p.m. daily. The Strand Bistro, West Cherry Street, downtown Jessup.
More from Monday's county meeting after an executive session Monday by the county commissioners. Commissioners Kevin McCreary and Ralph Hickox claim the county administrator Ed Jeffers violated state law and improperly illegally moved funds from one department to another without amending the budget without board approval as required by law. Hickox in his letter states he believes disciplinary action should have been taken, but he and McCreary could not get a third vote as commissioners Hires, Thomas, and Roberts not in favor of any action or even discussing the issue. Chairman Herschel Hires commented this is one reason why the amended budget issue on the agenda was tabled twice and eventually taken off the agenda altogether until the audit is complete. Administrator Ed Jeffers commented at the meeting saying he simply disagrees with Commissioner Hickox and McCreary's assessment of the moves in the budget.
And the interpretation you have, I don't think is correct. I understand what you read and what your concerns were, and you came to see me for a short period of time after that. Now, I gave y'all a budget analysis in February of what this was. Mr. Hickox asked for it, and I gave it out there. What I gave you in the budget is exactly what was there. Every year since 2013, which was the budget resolution over there to adopt or go by the GASB law, you got to reconcile and balance these budgets out. Amanda sent y'all a list that was what we're trying to get to approve for y'all, and that, get that up there. So it was an explanation of where everything was done for y'all's approval. No budgets, no nothing was changed. Even the auditors will tell you that, that the budget ended up just like it was that I sent you out in January of this year.
Now, we missed the budget largely, and that my explanation was for health care claims. Now, there's no money was changed up there. The interpretation, I apologize for the confusion from that standpoint, but no monies were manipulated without y'all. We were trying to explain, and there was some
what?
Mischews of words from that standpoint. So I'm committed to that point. We sent out, we give the budget to y'all every month. My point to that is, that ain't working well. That's why I've asked for a work session prior to every meeting. I want y'all's commitment on this. I want your input on this thing. And I want your understanding of what's going on from that standpoint. Because I need help. And I need help from all the way around up here. And you know, I need the communication back in two to come see me up there that we don't understand something. So that's all I got to say.
Right.
Jeffers went on to say this is one reason he asked for a second work session called meeting before every monthly meeting for the person discussing the budget. But Commissioner Ralph Hickox told him and the other board members that he asked for that exact same thing back in October, and it was simply voted down by the Board of Commissioners. Where this goes from here is anyone's guess. Both Hickox and McCreary stated Monday that this was not intended to be a public attack, but they both seemed frustrated that they laid out the facts to their fellow commissioners, wanted some kind of public reprimand, but the other commissioners will not go along with it. Again, we'll have more from the meeting on this week's newscast. Other items of action took place. We'll have those stories on Wednesday's newscast as well. We'll be back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor, the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
The Trademart at 3689 Savannah Highway has been serving Wayne County and surrounding counties for over 30 years. If it's a small hand tool you're looking for or a 30-ton bearing press, we've got it. You need a tarp? We've got you covered. We have any size you need, from a 5x7 to a 30x60. So if you need a quality tool at an affordable price, come see us at the Trademart, 3689 Savannah Highway, or call us at 427-6966. That's 427-6966. The Trademart, the tool supply place.
When you have an accident, you, not the insurance company, chooses the body shop, and you only need one estimate. All you have to do is call Jerome Riles at B&C Collision Center in downtown Scriven to deal with the adjusters and insurance company. Whether it's a little ding or a major crash, that B&C Collision Center across from Wasden Cabinet Shop in Scriven, deal with the insurance company so you don't have to. Call them at 579-2274. That's 579-2274.
And then along came Walker Jones.
Right now at Walker Jones Honda.
Discounts are rising faster than the summer heat, with APRs as low as 0.9 and 1.9 on select models to well-qualified buyers.
And take over $4,000 off on our new 2018 Honda Accords in stock.
Honda, the power of dreams.
Walker Jones. Online at walkerjoneshonda.com.
Hey, this is Kid Dean. Come down and see us at Walker Jones, home of the lifetime warranty. Lifetime.
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. N63019.
This is Charles Huffman at Jessup Housing Outlet. If you haven't been to Jessup Housing Outlet lately, you're missing out on a large selection of new and exciting floor plans from the nation's top manufacturers like Clayton, Fleetwood, Scottbilt, and Homes of Merit. All of our homes feature modern kitchens and appliances, R60 and higher insulation values, thermopane windows, and energy-efficient heat pumps. We have two locations to serve you, 2452 Savannah Highway in Jessup and Highway 301 South between I-16 and the bypass in Statesboro. Come see Charles, Fay, or Sheridan today.
Final notes and news. Wayne County Board of Education has a work session set for this afternoon at 6 p.m. at the Tech Center on the agenda. Request from the band boosters, also the high school athletic budget for last year and projections for this coming year with the athletic director Ken Cribb. School system will also discuss their 5-year facilities plan and their school food service procurement plan. All that today at 6. Have a full report for you tomorrow here on the local news. County meets again Friday morning at the airport at 9 a.m. for a call meeting to discuss the TSPLOS and the importance of the upcoming vote on the TSPLOS funding, and that's set for 9 a.m. this Friday at the Wayne County Airport. And once again, we'll have much more from Monday's call meeting as they reach an agreement on the Lake Grace lease. I have Ralph Hickox's 4 points where he says the administrator improperly and illegally moved funds from one department's budget to another without amending the budget. His 4th point states that Jeffers purposely didn't execute the will and official act of the commissioners. The board passed by a 5-0 vote to award a 15-year contract for J.C. Fairground Buildings to the Tourism Board in exchange for $3,000 in repairs. It was presented and passed, and the administrator was instructed to execute the contract. Hickox says the attorney, Andy Beaver, made the contract and delivered to Ed Jeffers, who held it without action for 2 years. According to the Tourism Board officials, Mr. Jeffers told them that the board changed their mind, which was not the case. Just one of 4 acts that Hickox laid out in his letter that was also released to the media at Monday's meeting. That's a look at the latest in local news. We'll be coming up with sports in a few minutes. Bob Morgan saying have a great day.
You've been listening to local news on WIFO.
Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048, that's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
You've just got to do it. Go to Just Gettin' By Thrift Store and check out the incredible bargains that is. It's like a flea market under one roof. Almost everything you need is there. Clothes, furniture, mattresses, decorative items, housewares, appliances, toys, specialty items, antiques, tools, stuff for pets, DVDs, and much more. It's an adventure in shopping at Just Gettin' By Thrift Store, located in the old Tramar building at 4133 Savannah Highway, a half mile past the Jessup Drive-In. Just Gettin' By Thrift Store. Lowest prices guaranteed.
Hi, good morning. Partly sunny. A 30% chance of afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Northeast breeze. Highs in the mid-80s. Tonight, mostly cloudy. Chance of showers and thunderstorms. Slight chance of showers late night. Lows upper 60s. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy. 50% chance of showers. Slight chance of thunderstorms. Low 80s. Thursday, all sunshine. Breezy. Highs in the mid-80s.
Georgia meteorologist John Weatherby in the GNN Weather Center.
Saturday, June 22nd, Wild Adventures Theme Park in Valdosta, Georgia presents 2019 Grammy Award winners Dan and Shay.
Nothing like you.
It's the Wild Adventures All-Star Concert Series featuring Dan and Shay live in concert Saturday, June 22nd.
I'm speechless.
Concert admission is included with your park admission or season pass.
Sky high in Colorado.
Get your tickets for Dan and Shay live in concert Saturday, June 22nd at wildadventures.com.
WIFOFM, Big Dog Country. Time to check your birthdays and anniversaries. Brought to you by Bargin Power Sports. Happy 20th birthday wishes today going out to Alex Arati. Alex Arati celebrating from Mom, Dad, Brad, and the rest of your family. We love you. Happy 20th birthday to Alex Arati today, 20 years old from the family. Happy 8th birthday to our little all-star Asher Edenfield from Mama, Daddy, and Harlem. Asher Edenfield, 8 years old. Happy 8th birthday, Asher Edenfield. Happy birthday, Mason Chestnut. Mason Chestnut celebrating this morning. From Uncle Johnny, May May, Caleb, Kristen, Joshua, and Jada, Mason Chestnut. Happy birthday to Mason Chestnut this morning. Happy birthday, Asher Edenfield. More wishes for Asher Edenfield today. From Uncle Alan, Riley, and Ryan for Asher Edenfield, who is 8 years old. Also from Aunt Juju and Uncle Stevie. Aunt Juju and Uncle Stevie wishing Asher Edenfield happy 8th birthday. Happy birthday, happy anniversary to my wife, Kay Arnold. I love you from Ray. Happy anniversary to my wife, Kay Arnold, with love from Ray. So Ray and Kay Arnold, happy anniversary. Happy 80th birthday to our papa, BJ Swartzlander. BJ Swartzlander, we love you from Asher and Harlan. Happy 80th birthday to papa, BJ Swartzlander, from Asher and Harlan. Happy birthday, Addison Jeffords. Addison Jeffords and Adina Tire. And Adina Tire from the Trapnels. Addison Jeffords and Adina Tire from the Trapnels this morning. Happy anniversary to Ray and Kay Arnold from the Sluter family. Ray and Kay Arnold from the Sluter family. And happy birthday, Deacon Yeomans. Deacon Yeomans, we love you, from the Sluter family this morning. Happy birthday to Revis Baxter. Revis Baxter. James Dorrance celebrating. James Dorrance. Yvonne Riggs. Yvonne Riggs. And Stephen Wright. Stephen Wright. Happy birthday from the Robin Eubank State Farm Gang. Long County calendar this morning on the 11th. Betsy Simmons celebrating. Betsy Simmons, happy birthday. Happy anniversary, Tina and Hal Skipper. Tina and Hal Skipper, happy anniversary. And more wishes for Revis Baxter. Revis Baxter, happy birthday. That is the Long County calendar this morning. Text OSOs at 912-427-3711 this morning. More wishes for Alex Arati. Happy birthday, Alex Arati. 20 from the Lastingers this morning for Alex Arati. Happy 48th anniversary to Ray, my love, love Kay. So that's Ray and Kay Arnold. 48th anniversary wishes to Ray with love from Kay this morning. Happy anniversary, Ray and Kay. Love your sister Jill, wishing Ray and Kay Arnold happy anniversary from your sister Jill. More wishes for Deacon Yeomans. Hope you have a great birthday from your best friend, Kennedy. Wishing Deacon Yeomans happy birthday from Kennedy. Deacon Yeomans from Kennedy this morning. Happy birthday to Missy Pie. Missy Pie from Lori, Tony, Marissa, Kelsey, and Appa. Wishing Missy Pie happy birthday. Missy Pie celebrating. Happy new 12th birthday to Deacon Yeomans from Aunt Tammy, Uncle Keith, and Kiefer for Deacon Yeomans 12. Also from Nanny and Papa wishing Deacon Yeomans happy 12th birthday. Hope your 12th is the best ever. Right, what do we have here? Happy 8th birthday to our all-star Asher Edenfield. Love Mama, Daddy, and Harlan this morning. 912-427-3711 via text. Birthdays, anniversaries on WIFO brought to you by Barger and Power Sports.
Famous birthdays today. Actor Jim Nabors was born in 1930.
Gomer Pyle, USMC. Starring Jim Nabors as Gomer Pyle.
Sportscaster Marv Albert is 78.
This one, exceptional game winner on the desperation pass. So Brownsburg High School beats Hobart High in the final seconds. Now,
former President George H.W. Bush was born in 1924.
Do your impression of me for me here right now. Don't tell me you're not God, Dad. So I said, all right. He goes, why don't you call the Secret Service guy? His name's Bob. See if he'll come in here. So I go, all right. And I go, Bob, come on in here. The guy walks in. Bush is like, I got an idea. Let's call the Premier of China.
We'll come back with your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on WIFO, and we'll do that right after this for Barger and Power Sports.
Barger and Power Sports invites everyone to come visit their unbelievable new showroom on Highway 301 South in Jessup and on Highway 341 in Brunswick. They have a great selection of ATVs, golf carts, mowers, and more. Barger and Power Sports carries Arctic Cat four-wheelers and side-by-sides, the new popular Can-Am four-wheelers and side-by-sides, cruise carts, and Yamaha golf carts. Barger's has the full line of Kymco scooters. Don't forget, Barger and Power Sports offers a complete service department for all your service and repair needs. Stop by today and check out Barger and Power Sports, Highway 301 South in Jessup, and their new location on Highway 341 next to I-95 in Brunswick.
Your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Tuesday morning. Happy 8th birthday, Asher Edenfield. Asher Edenfield picks up that cake from the Jessup Piggly Wiggly Bakery. Certificate of the station, you come by, you pick that up, it's good for today only. Head to the pig and claim your prize. Barger and Power Sports, Brunswick, Jessup, online, bargerandpowersports.com. Wishing Asher Edenfield happy 8th birthday of the Big Dog Country birthday cake winner. Happy 21st birthday to Zach Popple. Love your family. Zach Popple, 21, love your family. Bob will check in with local sports. We've got state news from GNN, a look at your weather forecast, and a whole lot more on a Tuesday morning here with the Big Dog, WIFO-FM. Good morning, 737.
Birthday.
Asher Edenfield, 8 years old, picks up the cake from the Jessup Piggly Wiggly Bakery. At 7:38, good morning from WIFO. Let's get a look at that GNN Weather Center forecast, brought to you this time by First Southern Bank, investing in you since 1907.
When it comes to growing a family business, we understand the business of growing. At First Southern Bank, we've been meeting the needs of South Georgia farmers for over 100 years. With competitive ag loan rates, including equipment loans, farmland loans, and lines of credit, First Southern Bank has all the banking tools you need to help keep your growing business growing. First Southern Bank.